Okay, welcome back to the channel, everyone. Thank you for taking time out of your day once again to check the video out. I appreciate all of the continued support. We have more PlayStation news, rumors, and leaks to go over and discuss. So before we dive into these topics today, do me a big favor and hit the like button to help this video out and show your support. And if you are new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well. The first topic we're discussing is something that has gained quite a bit of traction over the past 24 hours. More and more people are now paying attention to this because it seems to indicate that Sony is getting ready to announce something very soon, and it wouldn't surprise me if it actually comes in the next few weeks. So this is reading from Push Square, where they say PS Plus promotional language changes, fueling more Sony subscription rumors. So they say there's no smoke without fire, and clearly changes are afoot when it comes to PlayStation Plus and PlayStation Now. While Sony is yet to announce what its plans entail, Bloomberg has gone on record with internal documentation that hints at a new tiered subscription model. From what we understand, the existing PlayStation Plus model will continue to exist, but the platform holder will introduce higher tiers as it seeks to strengthen its services and close the gap with Microsoft's Game Pass. Last year, the manufacturer put 3-month subscriptions to streaming service PlayStation Now on sale, but kept the annual option at full price. It has since pulled 12-month subscription vouchers out of retailers in the UK and North America, so clearly changes are coming. And while this is admittedly a stretch, a fan on Twitter noticed that it changed the wording on February 2022's PlayStation Plus promotional banner. For well over a year now, it's subtitled its monthly PS Plus giveaways with the slogan, quote, for PlayStation Plus members, unquote. However, this month it changed the wording to, quote, available this month at no extra cost, unquote. The article continues by saying it's a minor thing, but it would perhaps reinforce the idea that additional tiers will be layered on top of the established PlayStation Plus offerings. We looked back through over a year's worth of PlayStation Plus giveaways, and there's no question the language has changed. It could, of course, mean nothing in the grand scheme of things, but the timing is suspicious considering the aforementioned Project Spartacus rumors. Now, at first glance, I can understand why this may seem pretty insignificant, but when you think about it, Sony has no reason at all to abruptly and intentionally change the wording on the PlayStation Plus promotional material. The only reason they would have to do something like that is if something is going to change or if something is going to be announced. At this point, it does seem that Sony is gearing up to reveal PlayStation Spartacus. Now, we've heard quite a bit about PlayStation Spartacus when it comes to, you know, reports and rumors, but I think the big question that many of us have, well, I have two questions, and you guys can let me know if you have these same questions. I want to know whether or not this is truly Sony's attempt to compete with Game Pass, because I feel like at this point, that's what a lot of people are expecting. That's what people are thinking Sony is going for with this Spartacus service. But I just don't know if that's actually their intention here. There's no doubt that Sony wants to make it known that, hey, we have our own service and we're putting, you know, more of a spotlight on it, but I just don't know that this is actually going to be a viable Game Pass competitor in the way that a lot of people are imagining it will be or should be. But the other question I have is, how exactly is Sony going to reveal this? Because we've been hearing rumors for quite a while now that Sony is doing something in February, and it seems like people are kind of torn on what this will be. Will it be a state of play? Will it be a full-blown event? Will it be something in between that? And when you think about Sony announcing something like PlayStation Spartacus, you know, it could kind of lean either way. If Sony doesn't want to make this that big of a deal, right? Like, it's just kind of something they want to casually announce and reveal and not really hype it up that much, they could do it during a state of play, right? But if they do want this to be something more significant, they do want this to be like, hey, this could potentially end up being our own version of Game Pass, PlayStation's version of Game Pass, and I have to imagine they would want to reserve a reveal for something more significant than a state of play, such as a full-blown event, right? That's just my speculation, but nonetheless, it does seem likely here, guys, that Sony is getting ready to do something with PlayStation Plus, and all signs are pointing to Sony gearing up to reveal PlayStation Spartacus. And it's interesting because I feel like PlayStation fans are kind of torn on this, right? Like, there are a lot of PlayStation fans that I see. They're very excited about what this is and what Sony's going to be doing. But there are also many, like myself, who really aren't that overly excited for it because I'm not the biggest fan of like services, right? I am certainly interested to hear what Sony has to say about this and how it's going to work. I mean, there's no doubt I'm going to want to talk about it and cover it and really kind of dissect it once we learn about it. But I'm not convinced at this point that it's something I'm actually going to want to subscribe to. And so I guess that's partly why I'm so interested in knowing more about it, because maybe Sony will announce something regarding the service that we're unaware of as of right now that'll completely change my mind and be like, yep, I definitely have to subscribe to the highest tier of Spartacus. But yeah, it's going to be very interesting. You know, I'm certainly anticipating a lot of interesting conversation going down once Sony reveals this and they announce it. And it seems like that's going to be happening sooner rather than later. So let me know your thoughts about this down in the comments below. Moving on to the next topic, we have another interesting rumor, this time regarding Kojima Productions. This is reading from PlayStation Lifestyle, where they say a new report suggests that Hideo Kojima is working on a PlayStation VR 2 game in collaboration with none other than award-winning virtual reality storyteller Celine Tricart. Twitter user OopsLeaks, whose recent reports have been backed up by trusted insiders, claims to have received quote, unconfirmed, unquote, information that one of Kojima Productions' smaller upcoming projects involves PSVR 2, a prototype or dev kit, of which he received back in November 2021. Kojima recently revealed that he's working on two projects, one of which is a big title and the other has been described as a new challenge. He later tweeted that he's toying with something radical. Kojima and Tricart are no strangers to each other, and the duo were previously part of the Venice Film Festival's grand jury for VR submissions. The revered veteran developer has also expressed his desire to experiment with VR before. And so I wanted to be sure to cover this for you guys because I think this is very believable. In fact, I think this is one of the most believable rumors we've heard regarding Kojima Productions and one of their upcoming projects. We know that Sony has a lot invested in PSVR 2. We know that Kojima is likely interested in making some type of VR game or VR experience. And considering Sony is going to be marketing this headset this year and kind of ramping everything up regarding PlayStation VR 2, I think getting a game from Kojima, even if it's a small one or just a small experience of some kind, from Kojima Productions and marketing, being able to market that alongside your new headset, I think that that would be a huge win for Sony. And again, I just think it would be really fascinating to see what somebody like Hideo Kojima could do with a VR game. And a lot of people are saying that they really hope, if this is true, he's working on a horror game. People are kind of saying, like, could you imagine what a PT-like experience would be like in VR? I think for a lot of people, that would be just a little too much. But I have to say, that's something I would also love to see as well. So yeah, I just wanted to report on this rumor, let you guys know this is what we have apparently a credible insider saying, or leaker, I should say. This is what they're saying about Kojima Productions. So we'll have to wait and see if this turns out to be true. Next up in line, we are talking about Horizon Forbidden West once again. Reading here from Push Square, it says Horizon Forbidden West is shaping up to be a monstrous open world RPG, and its 656-page strategy guide is further evidence of that. Future Press confirmed its hardback book will release towards the end of March, and it'll include a full breakdown of everything you should expect from Guerrilla Games' upcoming epic. Now, one of the things that was revealed with this upcoming strategy guide for Horizon Forbidden West is that apparently there will be more than 40 machines in total in Forbidden West. And this is definitely a significant number because in Horizon Zero Dawn, there were around 25 machines. So we're going from 25 total machines to now 40 seems like there is going to be way more this time around to deal with, and a lot more variety than there was previously. So this was something I noticed that I just wanted to let you guys know about. There is going to be a premium strategy guide, and we are now learning there's going to be 40 machines in total. Very awesome. But the final topic I have for you before ending this video talks about Destruction All-Stars, not a game I thought we would still be talking about at this point in time, but it seems that Destruction All-Stars is going to be free to play in the not too distant future. This is what is being reported by Reddit user Mr. Weewoo, who apparently during a maintenance period discovered through different codes the names of challenges that references free to play. Now, we don't have official confirmation of this yet, but this seems like the next logical step for a game like Destruction All-Stars. I believe it's still $20, and I have to imagine pretty much nobody is buying this game. The player base is likely shrinking and not growing, and because of that, making it free to play, it just seems like the right thing to do. It almost kind of makes you think maybe they should have done this from the start, but better late than never. We'll have to see if this does turn out to be true. I did hear that Lucid Games made a bunch of changes to Destruction All-Stars recently that have really improved the game, and I'm interested maybe if anybody listening to this has actually played the game since these updates were released. What do you think of it? Does it play a lot better? Do you think that it has more potential to actually be a successful game now that it's going to be free to play with these new changes they made? I'll be interested to hear what you have to say, but in the meantime, we'll just have to wait and see what they end up doing with it. But that's going to do it for this video, guys. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you did find it informative. Leave it a like if you did, subscribe if you're new, hit the bell notification icon, and feel free to share this video out on top of all that. But until next time, guys, take care.